days. Listen, listen. You don't even need to ask me any questions.
I'm gonna say I'm not saying anything.
You don't even need to ask me any questions right about now. Listen, at Palace, I said it. There's two ways you want to win a game. You want to win a game by blowing the team completely out of the water, or even better, by building character, coming back from the death, coming back from the brink, showing pride, passion, heart, belief. Yes. And that's what Manchester United did today. Listen, listen. It was a game against our fiercest rivals. It was a game against these lot who thought they were going to win the league today. Pep thought, oh, you know what? I'm going to come out here. I'm going to put any side. I'm going to field some weak team to embarrass them. What did we do? Listen, they brought on who? Kevin De Bruyne. They brought on who? Aguero. Oi. What? So what, mate?
Hey, all right? Let me tell you, me and Dave, 2-0 down, half time. We said to each other, hey, 3-2, we can do that. Hey, do you know what? We had a few Twitter trolls as well.
Yeah.
We had a few Twitter trolls. How do we even see that?
I was one of them. I was saying, boys, you're talking shit.
We're at a football stadium and we somehow had perfect signal. Why?
Yeah, it was like this, Etihad. It was like, listen, there's no way. We were streaming the game, yeah, live from the car park. And it was like, hold on, mate. There is no game. We was at
Southampton.
Yeah, we was at Southampton yesterday, the Lionesses, the England women's versus Wales. And listen, we couldn't get a freaking ounce of signal. I couldn't put out a tweet. I couldn't even put out a little WhatsApp. But over here, ain't no one here. No one here but United fans. You know what I'm saying?
So you know what? It got to 2-1. Got to 2-2. 3-2, and you know what? The two players who have got the most criticism.
Yeah, man.
Paul Pogba and Alexis Sanchez.
Aye.
Say what?
And you know what? Chris Smalling as well, though.
Oi! Chris Mike Smalling! Oi. Hey, listen, the funny thing about it is...
First half Chris, second half Mike.
Hey, listen, it's a...
It was, that's literally, literally.
Hey, the bars! First half Chris, second half Mike!
And you know what? A special shout out to Jose Mourinho, because you know what? Yeah. If Pep Guardiola had done that, yeah, he would be a genius.
They'd have statues up out here.
Listen, there'll be effigies going. People will be talking. Listen. Jose Mourinho has been absolutely class today. Absolutely class, because he gets the stick when Man United don't perform. And he should get the praise today when bringing them back from halftime. It looked like a completely different side.
Mate, to be a fly on the wall in that dressing room at halftime. What has been said, man? Hey. I feel like just as pumped like after I've chatted with you than I bet them players would have done after that, mate. Honestly. What was said? What was said, man? I can't even
And you know
think.
What me and Dave was even talking about? We're saying, look, this game doesn't really mean anything to us in the sense of points. It doesn't really matter. Look, we're still going to finish top four. We're still going to be in and about. It doesn't really make a difference. But that performance showed in the second half that we played for the rivalry. We played for the badge. We played for everything that actually matters about this football club. That's what it showed.
Hey, mate, that's worried that we always think like some players, we criticise them, don't we? We say they don't even look like they want to play for United. And second half, so many players then. I think that Jose might have said at half time, look, if you don't put in a performance, you're off in the summer.
Listen,
you're gone,
listen,
some of you
listen.
Lot. And then they've just thought, I want to play for Man United. You know, I want to play for Manchester United.
We rattled them.
Listen, the best thing about this entire thing is the performance was like a performance for next season. It was putting a stamp on the fact that, listen, one, we can do it. Two, we can do it against the top opposition. And three, listen, players need experiences like this where character is built. This players need that. This was Manchester United of old. Never say die. It doesn't matter what the scoreline is. Doesn't matter what it is at halftime. It doesn't matter. We've done it against Tottenham. We've done it against Chelsea. We brought it back from the brink. And these players need that character building experience. And they did it today. That is going to be massive going into next season.
100%. I don't even know what else to say, lads. I'm just so fucking buzzing. Honestly, I'm so buzzing. But next season, right? Going into next season now, what are you thinking? Like, what has got to be the target now? Because... I mean, for me, it's got to be a challenge. It's got to be a proper title challenge.
Listen, next season, Manchester United just need to focus on themselves. I said this the other day. I was like, listen, win your games. Don't worry about what's going on over here. Don't worry about these, man. Worry about yourself. Win your games. Beat Southampton. Beat Newcastle. Beat these men we drop points to. And we'll be in and amongst it. We'll be right up there and in the game. I said this, listen, I was saying this to Akeem earlier on. Listen, Paul Pogba, 2 P's. Party people, hey. 2 P's. How about that?
No coincidence!
Mate, fucking love it, man. Oh,